I tell you, it's just the way things are. This, I came all the way up into the end of this canyon, the San Gabriel Canyon, and there's this little cafe up here, and my camera wouldn't work. And there's snow up here, and there's this little guy, this little Greek guy, who runs this cafe. After 9 years, this place got burned out, and after 9 years of fighting the government, he finally got to come back up here and open up this cafe. And he's living up here in this great little cabin. He's got two or three other cabins, and it's the Forestry Service. He's been dealing with these typical government assholes for years, trying to get this done. And they kept running him in circles, all these bureaucrats, people behind desks and counters, you know, making him pay all these fees and ripping him off for hundreds and thousands of dollars. And he finally got this place back open. And then my camera ran out of juice, and I couldn't shoot it while I was there. And I got to get down the mountain before it gets dark. So it's like the sun is going down. I see this place, and he says, this campground down here, I should keep it like this, this campground down here is the government, typical. You know, they came in, they put in millions of dollars and put in 300 space campground and all these privies that cost $30,000 or $40,000 each. And then they closed it because they wouldn't pay one or two people as employees to stay here and just sit by the campground and and take people's money who came up camping. So they just left it open all summer, and nobody knew it was here, because he says, one government agency, you've got Caltrans, who rebuilt the road, and they wanted him to come up here and open it back up, but they're fighting with the National Park Service that wants to turn it into a park, and they're fighting with the Forestry Service, who wants to keep control of it, and they're fighting with the county, who wants to keep control of it. And then they've got the, look at that moon. Oh, my God. Look at this shot. Oh, my God. Look at this. I just realized it's a full moon. And I'm up in the mountains. And I'm hearing this horror stories from this guy. We've been talking for hours up here. And it's like up here at this place called Crystal Lake. And you've got all these idiotic, even the Azusa Chamber of Commerce came up here because they wanted him to open the business. And they were fighting with Caltrans. And, these idiot bureaucrats, you know, this social, even he said it was communism. I go, yeah, it's socialism. It's what they're trying to do to the country. They're trying to make the entire country state, you know, the Soviet state. And they say, oh, we're fixing this up for the people. But they really don't want the people having access to it. But here it is, this fantastic place up here. And I've got just enough light to shoot. And he says they want somebody to run this campground up here. There's the snow. There's snow on the ground. Look at this. There's snow on the ground up here. It's November, 8th. I haven't seen snow on the ground close up for almost 10 years because I haven't been back to Ohio. I got to keep watching my speed. It's going to take me forever to get back down this. Look at this. Look at this. See, I can't look. I am way, way up here. This is, I don't know how many miles it is, but it's 5,000, over 5,000 feet elevation. And I came up, and there were deer. And he said there was a fire up here in 2002, and I remember that. Because that was the year they had all these massive fires out here. And it turns out they were being set by some illegal running around, you know, setting all these fires. And the one up here, I thought it was the trees were dead from the pollution or something. But they're still there from all the fires. But all these other trees came back. And this area, Caltrans came up and opened up the road. And here's this little Greek guy. Little Greek guy, you know, and his wife made this banana bread that was just incredible. He brings out this bag of, he doesn't even know what it is. He can't, there's no English name for it. It's like this spice. It's little seeds. and he grinds it up and puts it in the bread. It's a Greek, it's from Greece. My mother sends it here. She sent me 3 kilo every couple of months. I'm like, whoa, and this stuff. And here I was, you know, I'm pissing and moaning about down by the beach where all these, you know, cops up my ass and, you know, people in Malibu. And I come up here and it's like, this is what I've been thinking about for the past couple of months. You know, I thought the beach would be great, but it ain't. It ain't the place where I want to be. And I thought, well, I go back to Ohio. What have I got? $4,000 maybe to my name? I go back to Ohio. I can't buy any property there. You know, there's no real work. I'd end up back in Columbus trying to, you know, what, buy another old car and try to operate a some kind of service or something? Or work for some, worse yet, work for some piece of shit? Look at, oh, you can't see it now. The camera won't pick it up. This is so gorgeous up here. Look at this. And it's this, the camera died on me, and it wouldn't work. I couldn't take pictures of the campground. And he's got these cabins, and it's right at the end of this canyon. And there's a lake up here. And he says, oh, yes, I'm a small guy. I keep low profile. The government, you know, they said people up here had big plans. They don't want that. I said, oh, I don't want big plans. All I want is to, I want someplace like this that is just, I can be, you know, and exist and have, and enjoy it. And this is my ideal up here. See, even this camera doesn't adjust for the light very well. There's this orange glow, probably from the deadly shit they're spraying. Because out here, most of it's glow. I'm going to hit a rock. I'm just going crazy up here. It's dusk. And what a place. There's almost nobody up here. Because they kept it quiet. And there's the valley down there. And you can see, you know, Orange County and San Bernardino down there. What a spot. What a spot. And unlike down by the beach, I saw absolutely no rangers up here. Nobody giving me shit. Nobody demanding to see an ID or you know, oh, have you got your permit? Fuck you with all this shit, man. So he said he's got a cabin. I was going to stay up here, and then I realized I got to move the RV by 10 o'clock. Fuck. If I had put the RV in Malibu on the side of the road, I could have stayed up here for the night. Look at this. This spot you can see all the way down. And I am way up here. This is like, it took a good hour to get up here. So it's going to be pitch black by the time I get down to the bottom. Anyway, I got to quit talking because this is going too long. But what a spot. What a place. I'm going to call the Park Service guy. He gave me the guy's name. I'm going to see about, you know, operating this campground and bringing... I told this guy, I said, you know, I could bring people up here. Turns out the guy is like, he's like a 4-star chef. And he's flipping burgers up here at this little carryout cafe. Because it's his dream. Look at this. Look at this moon. Look at this. Up here in the mountains. And it's, I mean, right above the Los Angeles Basin. I wouldn't even have known it was here. And I've been thinking about this, and it just, there it is. There's my place I want to move to. Anyway, enough of that. We shall see.